Well, hi there. This is Chloe, and I'm here to give you a really fun fact for today. The question is, where do baby alligators come from? And to answer that question will be different depending on if you're wondering about real-life American alligators or stuffed alligators. But let's compare the two. We know that our cute plush alligators are made out of lots of love, soft fabric, stuffing, and are delivered by mail. From there, they may be taken to the person who will be their new BFF by way of a parent, maybe sent as a birthday gift, or some might get their new home by way of Santa's sleigh. But real-life alligators are not brought in about the same way. Real-life alligators are actually hatched from eggs. Yes, we know how the stork does not deliver baby alligators. In fact, storks probably try to stay away from alligators unless they want to become a snack. But did you know that most adult alligators are pretty much loners? Well, that is until mating season. By the time April and May come around and the waters are starting to warm up, the gators are out of their winter hibernation. This is when people might start seeing alligators out and about. In the late spring, you might hear or see large groups of gators coming together to do what some call a billowing chorus. This group normally gets together within a couple of hours after sunrise. All of the gators are looking for good mates, and that's why they do this. Stuffed plush gators do not really like being alone, and they love to be around people and other stuffed animals, much like myself. Although they do like to hibernate each night by cuddling under the blankets with you. But back to the real-life alligators. The males have a very deep sound that can be heard or felt from a very long ways away, above and below water. They show what big, strong guys they are by arching their neck and tail above the surface. Well, actually they're showing the females their neck as a gesture of good intentions, because their neck is very vulnerable. In fact, the males will sometimes show off by doing what they call a head slap. Yes, the males will slap the surface of the water with their heads. It gives a whole new meaning to headbanging. The head slapping, arching, and growl is not only to impress the females, but it's also to warn other males that they better not come in their area. If a male is not having much luck charming the ladies in the swamp, he may get out and go to another pond. To top off this gator speed dating, the animal puts off a scent through their musk glands. I'm not sure I'd want to get close enough to take a whiff. Most of our furry animals at Fuzzy Wuzzy don't blow, and they don't really stink, but they may cause giggles. I've also never noticed if our plushies are male or female, except I know I'm a girl, but that's a different story. And there is currently no head slapping. Plush gators just impress you with their cuteness. I will also point out that none of our plush gators smell of musk. Or did I already say that? Yeah, I think it would really cut into their adorableness. But once again, back to the real life gators. After all of the billowing, you might see what is called a mating dance. They will rub next to each other and bob up and down. They will test each other's strength by pushing the other one underwater. I mean, geesh, up until the part of pushing or shoving your potential mate underwater, it sounds like an episode of Jersey Shore. Glad plushies don't get this crazy. But once a female is mated, she's off to build her nest. And the male is just back to his old boring life and has nothing to do with the nest building, the eggs, or even the young. Then, in late June or July, the female will lay her eggs. Most healthy females lay between 30 to 50 eggs at a time. She then covers her eggs with vegetation where they will be hidden for 65 whole days. The mama gator may not sit on her nest all day, but she is around to keep an eye on it. And, of course, to protect it. Here's something really neat. How is it determined if the hatchlings will be male or female? Well, it's determined by the temperature of the nest. If the temps are between 82 to 86 degrees Fahrenheit, the babies will be all female. And if the developing temps are between 90 and 93 degrees, they will be all male. And anything between 87 to 90 degrees could turn out hatchlings of both male and female. The baby alligators will then call out to their mother when it's time for hatching. The mom will then come over and uncover all of the nest and let the new ones tear out of their egg with a specialized egg tooth. The little hatchlings are about 6 inches long and will grow up to a foot within a year. These babies also have a mom to protect them until she goes off for mating season in the next spring. When babies are about 10 to 12 years old, which they're not really babies at that point, but when they're that old and about 6 feet long, they will start families of their own. But now that we know about them, I can tell you that stuffed plush gators need you to play with, and they don't grow any larger, and they won't have babies of their own. But now that you know the difference between real gators and plush gators, maybe you can see why humans prefer stuffed animals rather than go into swamps and try to get